Five things I would not do as a professional resume writer. Most people know, some of you don't, that for 12 years I ran a resume writing company, helped thousands of people get new jobs. It was very fulfilling and rewarding. I have since retired, but I saw this trend, thought it was fun. Here are five things I would not do as a certified professional resume writer. Number one, don't put your birth year at the end of your email address. A lot of people make this mistake. Your email will be Jane Doe 68, John Doe 72. Everyone knows that your birth year, age discrimination absolutely happens, and that can affect your opportunities depending on what sector you're in, where you live, and what you're looking to do. Number two, don't freak out about the one-page resume length myth. If you have 15, 20 years of experience and you're still freaking out about trying to cram it all on the one page, you are probably selling yourself short. It is perfectly acceptable to have two pages at least in order to adequately describe your experience. And in some industries, such as the public sector or academia, it can be even longer. So don't freak out about one page. Number three, don't just describe your job duties on your resume for each position you've held. That's very generic and boring. That does not make you stand out. Show your accomplishments for each position so that you can see a positive track record, and quantify your experience with metrics and numbers. My first job out of college was working for Enterprise Rent-A-Car. So instead of saying assisted in the management of a rental car branch servicing customers, you look at it and say, okay, assisted in managing a fleet of 150 cars worth approximately $3 million for the largest rental company in America. That's how you quantify your experience. And I got $3 million by averaging approximately $20,000 per car times 150. That's how you have to look at it on your resume in order to quantify your experience and make yourself stand out. Number four, do not go about your career without utilizing networking services such as LinkedIn. It boggles my mind how many people opt out of using LinkedIn. There's so much value you can get there from networking and job opportunities. It's unbelievable. Number five, and this is the most painful, be mindful that racism does still exist in the hiring sector. And if you have a very ethnic sounding name, there could be discrimination or judgment going against you that's limiting your job opportunities. Some of my best clients, we had to use more common sounding names, and it absolutely made a difference. I hate to say that, and I'm sorry, but it's still true.